Culture, we've been trained for individual differences to stand out. So you look at each person, immediate hit is brighter, dumber, older, younger, richer, poorer, and we make all these dimensional distinctions, put them in categories and treat them that way. And we get so that we only see others as separate from ourselves in the ways in which they're separate. And one of the dramatic characteristics of experience is being with another person and suddenly seeing the ways in which they are like you, not different from you, and experiencing the fact that which is essence in you and which is essence in me is indeed one. The understanding that there is no other. It is all one.
How are we going to keep building nuclear weapons? You know what I mean? What's going to happen to the arms industry when we realize we're all one?
You ever hear about in this country is our differences. That's all the media and the politicians are ever talking about, the things that separate us, things that make us different from one another.
It's time for a new philosophy, folks. One based on, yes, the principles of Jesus, which were love your brother as yourself, because you know what? He is yourself. Literally. We are literally all one.
I woke up and I suddenly got it. I understood suddenly how thought was just an illusory thing. And how thought is responsible for, if not all, most of the suffering we experience. And then I suddenly felt like I was looking at these thoughts from another perspective. And I wondered, who is it that's aware that I'm thinking? And suddenly I was thrown into this expansive, amazing feeling of freedom from myself, from my problems. I saw that I was bigger than what I do. I was bigger than my body. I was everything and everyone. I was no longer a fragment of the universe. I was the universe. And ever since that day, I've been trying to get back there. Comes and goes. It's like riding a wave. Sometimes I'm on, sometimes I'm off. And we are all one thing. It really is true.
discovery of this connection would force us to rethink the nature of reality itself. The world we think we know, the solid, reassuring world of our senses, turns out to be just a tiny sliver of an infinitely weirder, more wonderful universe than we could have ever conceived of in our wildest fantasies. Our reality is just an illusion.
Progress in our understanding of the universe through physics over the past quarter century has been exploring deeper levels of natural law, from the macroscopic to the microscopic, from the molecular to the atomic to the nuclear to subnuclear levels of nature's functioning, so-called electroweak unified scale, grand unified scale, super unified scale. And what we've discovered at the core basis of the universe, the foundation of the universe, is a single universal field of intelligence, a field which unites gravity with electromagnetism, light, with radioactivity, with the nuclear force, so that all the forces of nature and all the so-called particles of nature, quarks, leptons, protons, neutrons, are now understood to be one. They're all just different ripples on a single ocean of existence. That's called the unified field or superstring field, and it's a mathematical tour de force. But we have realized Einstein's dream. He dedicated half of his life to discovering this unified field, and now in the context of the superstring, that has been achieved. So unified field theory is based on the superstring identifying a single universal field of intelligence, an ocean of existence, at the basis of everything, mind and matter. And all the so-called particles of the universe, the forces in our universe, everything in the universe, are just ripples of on that ocean of existence. That's the unified field. And that field is a non-material field. It is ultimately the field of consciousness. And all our separate consciousness, wherever there's consciousness, is merely consciousness by virtue of the fact that my consciousness, your consciousness, are ultimately that. Everything in the universe is really nothing but that. Planets, trees, people, animals, we're all just waves of vibration of this underlying unified superstring field. We are really united at our core. And ultimately the understanding that's emerging will be that there is only one consciousness in this room. And it is you. And it is me. And it is each and every one of us. We individualize our consciousness through the filter of our nervous system. But the consciousness itself, our very inner subjectivity, the self in the big sense, that is universal. And knowing that, knowing it through experience, is called enlightenment, and has been called enlightenment through the ages.
It sounds like you're going down through the physical realms, leptons, you know, smaller, smaller, and you're saying at the base, it's not solid, it's intelligence. Why do you use the word intelligence?
That is a very brilliant question. What you're saying really reflects a bias that all of us share. Everyone who's grown up in the scientific world is used to the concept that we're living in a material universe, an inert universe, a universe of dead matter. And because of that, it's difficult instinctively to grasp that we're not really living in a dead universe, that the universe is overwhelmingly conscious at its basis. See, what we have seen and studied for 300 years of classical physics is what we call billiard ball mechanics, macroscopic physics, classical physics, the physics of billiard balls, cannonballs, and planets. But quantum mechanics, even at the molecular level, let alone atomic, nuclear, subnuclear, in the realm of quantum mechanics, the idea of particle is replaced by the idea of wave function. And what is a wave function? Technically, it's a vector in a linear space. But what's a vector in a linear space? What's it made of? What's the substance of nature? Well, a wave function, a vector in a linear space, is made of the same stuff thoughts are made of. We're really living in a thought universe, a conceptual universe. Quantum mechanics is just the play and display of potentiality. So the point I'm making is the deeper you go in the structure of natural law, the less material, the less inert, the less dead the universe is, the more alive, the more conscious the universe becomes. Then when you get to the foundation of the universe, the unified field or superstring field, it's simply a field of pure being, pure intelligence. Intelligence, because it's the fountainhead of all the laws of nature, all the fundamental forces, all the fundamental particles, all the laws governing life at every level of the universe have their unified source in the unified field. That makes the unified field the most concentrated field of intelligence in nature. Non-material, dynamic, self-aware intelligence. Those are the properties of the unified field. But when you have to ask the question, waves of what, really? What is the field that is waving? Is it the ocean? No, it's a universal ocean, an ocean of pure potentiality, an ocean of abstract potential existence. We call it the unified field or superstring field. And that's what we're made of. So, as you said, the tighter physics have tried to grasp onto physical reality, to understand what it's really made of, what are the core building blocks of life, at the basis of it all. Life, the universe, slips through your fingers, and you come up with something that's increasingly abstract, to come to the realm of pure abstraction. And that's what the unified field is. It's pure abstract potential, pure abstract being, pure abstract self-aware consciousness, which rises in waves of vibration to give rise to the particles, the people, everything we see in the vast universe.
That was great. I got awesome. Goosebumps on that one.
So it may take a generation, unfortunately, it may take a generation. Now that simple techniques, universal, non-sectarian, scientifically verified techniques exist to gain enlightenment, it still may take a generation before these life-saving technologies to develop consciousness are reintroduced into education.
You said non-sectarian. Does that mean like non-religious? Is that what that you mean by that?
The experience of pure consciousness really transcends any one religion or any one philosophy. It's as scientific as it is religious. It is, after all, a state of functioning of the brain, maximally expanded comprehension. It's the direct subjective experience of the scientifically discovered unified field of all the laws of nature. Is that religious? Perhaps, but it's scientific too. So there's no reason that it should be disbarred from education. Otherwise, we're going to get the same old result. 5% development of our mental potential, another generation of war and terrorism and human cruelty. And that'll go on forever until the experience of life's essential unity is bestowed and the brain is properly developed. It's that one aspect of our experience that has been with us since childhood. Although our beliefs have changed, our friends have changed, our bodies have changed, typically for the worse, that one thing that gives that continuity to our experience day by day, that's our consciousness. It's our subjectivity. It's the Atman, the self.